Hello children, in this video I will discuss two questions of exercise 7.3. First one is, how many words with or without meaning can be made from the letter of the words Monday? Assuming that no letter is repeated if first one is four letters are used at a time. Now here, with or without meaning, you have to form some words by using a word Monday. Now, first of all, whatever word is given to you, whichever is given to you, you have to find out how many letters are there in a given word. So here we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Total 6 letters are there. Now, in a question they have given 4 letters are used at a time. 4 letters are used at a time. Now, how many letters are there? 6. Among 6, how many letters I have to use? 4 letters. So, it will be 64. So, your answer will be 6 factorial upon 6 minus 4 factorial, that is 6 into 5 into, in a denominator, let me write down first of all, 6 minus 4, that is 2 factorial, 2, 4 into 3 into 2, 2, 2, cancel out, multiply, you can get your answer. Now, next one is here. All letters are used at a time. All letters are used at a time. How many letters are there? 6. Among 6, all letters are I have to use. All 6. So that time when all letters are used, that time your arrangement will be, because here I have to arrange letters. So it will be, whenever we have to do arrangement, it means we have to apply a permutation concept. So that time 6P6. So here it will be 6 factorial upon 6 minus 6 factorial. 6 minus 6 means 0 factorial. 0 factorial means 1. So here 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2. Multiply, you can get your answer here. Now here, last one is, all letters are used, but first letter is vowel. Now here they are saying that we have to use all letters, but first letter is vowel. Whenever they are giving a condition for the particular place, so that time what you have to do, it will be better, we will apply a principle of counting. So here, how many places are there? 6. Among 6, first one should be vowel. How many vowels are there? O and A. So, first place I can fill by two ways. Now, among 6 only one letter is here. So, how many are left with me? 5. If I use one more here, so now I have 4. One more I will use here, then 3. Here 2 into 1. Multiply this all, you will get your answer. Like that you can solve it. Now, next question which is very important. Last one is, in how many of the distinct permutations of the letter in the Mississippi? Here, word is given Mississippi, M-I-S-S-I-P-P-I. This word is given to you, Mississippi. Do the four I's not come together? Here, they are asking that I have to do arrangement in such a manner that four I's should not come together. Now here, whenever a word given, and by using that word, if we have to find out how many number of words we can arrange, how many maximum arrangement can be possible here. So that possibility is to find out what we will do. First of all, what we have to do, we have to count how many letters are there. So that letter will be your numerator. Now, second thing, what I should write down in a denominator? After that, I have to count each letter is repeating what many number of times. So by that many factorial, I have to divide. So here, total number of arrangement is equals to how many letters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So it will be 11 factorial. Now I will count. M is coming only one time. I have 1, 2, 3 and 4. So 4 times. S 1, 2, 3, 4. So S is again repeating 4 times. After that, P. P is coming 2 times. So, what I should do to find out total number of arrangement possible? So, first of all, I have to count how many letters are there. So, that many factorial will be a numerator. After that, in a denominator, M is coming for only one time. So, no need to write down because 1 is a multiplicative identity. I is repeating 4 number of times. So, in a denominator, 4 factorial. S is repeating again 4 number of times. So, it will be 4 factorial. And P is repeating 2 times. So, in here, 2 factorial will come. After that, now here we have to find out all I should sum together. Your question is all I not come together. Okay. All I not come together, here I have to find out. So, in a question what you have to do, total number of arrangement I have calculated. After that, in a question they are asking all I should not come together. So what I will do, from a total, if I will subtract all I coming together, then I can easily find out all I not coming together, like a probability. P of E plus P of E bar, which is equals to 1. Suppose I want to find out P of E, what I should do? 1 minus P of E bar. From a whole I subtracting its complement, I will get P of E. Similarly, if I want to find out P of E bar, what I should do? From a 1, I will subtract P of E. So like that here also, from a total number of arrangement, I will subtract all I's coming together. So if I subtract that, then I will get easily all I's are not coming together. So here, now I will find if all I come together, then it will be. Now see, if all I, 1, 2, 3, 4, this all I should come together. It means that time this all 4 I will be considered as one letter. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4 I am considering as a 1. Because it is a group. This group, of whenever I have to keep on a first place, second place, third place, fourth place, whatever way, on that place, all I should come. So that time, that all 4 I will acquire only one position. So here, in place of counting 4 times I, I will count only one time. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 1 for I. So here, my numerator will be 8 factorial. Now, denominator M is repeating only one time. No need to write down again. Here I in place of 4 times I. Now I am considering it for one time because it will be considered as a one position. Now S is coming 4 factorial time and P is repeating 2 factorial time. Now in a question they are asking all I should not come together. So how I will get number of arrangement where all I should not come together, that time it will be 11 factorial upon 4 factorial into 4 factorial into 2 factorial minus this quantity 8 factorial upon 4 factorial into 10 factorial. Now how to open this, how to subtract it? That all things you are knowing, but even though I will simplify it a little bit, 11 into 10 into 9 into 8, 7, 6, 5 into 4 factorial divided by 1 time 4 factorial I am keeping as it is, 2 into 2, minus here also 8, 7, 6, 5. 4 factorial will be cancelled with this inner denominator. Now you have 2. This 4 factorial, 4 factorial will be cancelled out. 4 2's are 8 again cancel out. 3 2's are 6 cancel out. Here it will be 4. So now you have 11 into 10 into 9 into 7 into 5 minus 7 into 6 into 5 into 4. Multiply this group and subtract it. While you will subtract it, here you are getting 33810. This is your answer. Hope this question understood to you.